600 feet below ground in the middle of this old NORAD base, and just coming down that tunnel in the van and you just keep going, it almost seems unreal. It almost seems like some giant set or some amusement park ride. I was playing the Gap Band's You Dropped a Bomb on Me coming in here today because it just seems so bizarre.
Bill Paxton, we were just sort of like shooting the shit, and he's like, oh my God, the world could be over and we wouldn't know. And I was like, that is a really terrifying feeling. Thank you, Bill.
You are now officially on D&D property.
Inside this mountain, in this old NORAD complex, it was very, very strange and eerie because it was so old and it's kind of been disused for a long time. The folks in North Bay refer to it as the hole.
Mason!
By the end of the day, you start getting a little bit more tired than you normally would. There's a bit less oxygen down here, I think, than most places.
We've locked us out of here.
Yes.
My dad works in a lime quarry, so I'm a little familiar with this sort of thing.
And action!
I'm surprised that we're able to shoot in here, to be honest. It's so perfect for the movie. It's such a big facility that we got really lucky that we're able to sort of show something that I'm sure most people in the world have never seen.
Pierre, our DP, has been instrumental in kind of figuring out how to get some of our bigger set pieces done in the most efficient manner. One of them being the bridge sequence, which we shot for 4 days. And part of the challenge of it is, you know, the bridge in the real world of the movie is 500-600 feet long. But we were, of course, only able to build a 100-foot section of it. We were able to kind of break that down and reuse that same section of bridge and just dressing it differently.
I worked really hard on visual effects with art department also to make this set, you know, high enough so we don't shoot too much green screen or low enough or wide enough.
He's working with our production designer, taking their models, bringing it in. We would have meetings and we would literally line up shots in SketchUp and animate the camera move. So before we shot the bridge sequence, we pretty much had a previs of the entire sequence, so we could show everybody on the crew exactly what the shot was. And it really just made things that much more efficient and clear to everybody.
We shot in an airplane hangar, and we built a studio inside there. We opened the door and brought real snow. So the actors were walking on real snow. And we would get also the breath, which is very important.
Closer to camera, closer to camera.
And the first day we start shooting, and after the first shot, the lenses froze, which I've never seen this ever in my life. We got the day. It was a long day.
Action up top.
It's certainly topical. It's almost a popular culture zeitgeist with post-apocalyptic films now.
This was a movie that when I read it, I thought to myself, I've never seen this movie before.
This is one where I sort of feel fortunate that I get to be part of.